guys are protesting outside a Cardinals baseball game.
Yes.
You do realize that they aren't burying any soldiers here, don't you?
You do realize that we pick at any occasion when there's masses going in. We're preaching to the whole world. This is the second day of our Godsmack tour. We're heading to the United States Supreme Court.
We're on a mission from God.
We're going up I-70 all the way to Washington, D.C. We're stopping all along the way.
If you're thinking of taking the tribe cross country, this is the automobile you should be using, the Wagon Queen Family Truckster.
What does God smack mean?
God smack? God smacks you daily.
Hey! Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, you fat penguin!
Because of this. Smack in this country, left and right.
I slap you. I'm slapping you silly because you disrespected me.
This nation has gone the way of Sodom. In all of her institutions, she promotes condoned sin.
Well, you can do what you want to us, but we're not going to sit here and listen to you bad mouth the United States of America.
So, see the things going on in this
God
country?
God loves everybody.
No, he doesn't, hon. He hates
God
you.
God loves everybody.
You're going to hell.
Your language is offensive.
For Sodom and Gomorrah, this nation is going to be destroyed in like manner. It's going to be an awesome and terrible thing, and there's going to be convulsions of the land and bodies spewing. That's the Bible language.
What do you mean, biblical?
What he means is Old Testament, Mr.
Yes.
Mayor. Real wrath of God type stuff.
Exactly. Human sacrifice, dogs and cats living together, mass hysteria.
He says that he hates 99.9% of the majority. Jesus Christ said, straight is the gate, and narrow is the way that leads to life out of heaven, and few there be that find it. But broad and easy is the way that leads to destruction, and many go in thereat. The majority of mankind is going to hell.
So you're telling me there's a chance?
Well, then why did he die?
He died for his people. And it uses an elect remnant. A remnant is a small piece of something. It's a small portion of mankind. The word remnant is in the Bible. The word elect is in the Bible. The word predestination is in the Bible.
Wait. We're predestined?
Yes. Before he ever even created the world, he set out all the things that were going to happen. He said who he was going to love and who he was going to hate before he ever created us.
So when we're born, we're already either chosen or not chosen?
Correct. And it says,
well, then what's it matter what we do?
When Esau was in the womb,
if we're chosen, what's it matter what we do?
Because God says you're supposed to obey.
Okay, but if I'm chosen at birth to go to heaven.
If you're chosen to go to hell, well, tough. You're still going to go to hell. You're still going to be hell.
Well, wait. No, you're ignoring the other part of this.
Okay.
If I'm chosen to go to heaven.
Uh-huh.
And I end up becoming a sodomite.
No, hon, because you're not going to become a sodomite.
Why not?
I'll cradle the balls, stroke the shaft, work the pipe, and swallow the grating.
That's why Christ died. Because...
for our sins.
Not for our sins. For the people that he loves, that he predestinated.
You keep using the word. I do not think it means what you think it means.
Well, then just for your sins?
Not necessarily for mine. I'm not special in any way. But there's manifestation whether or not God loves you or hates you. If you're a sodomite, God hates you.
I've always loved you.
Why are you guys so obsessed with homosexuality?
Because, hon, Jesus Christ was obsessed with homosexuality.
Now, do you think you're reading it kind of selectively?
No, hon. The problem is you don't read it. Hon, don't be so simplistic. Jude.
I can't help it.
You have to be penitent. You have to be ashamed of your sin. You can't march down Main Street saying, I'm so proud of my filthy fag sin. You can't do that.
Well, what if you're a homosexual and you're ashamed of it?
Well, let me tell you about that. In Romans 1, it says the nature of that sin is that they're not ashamed of it.
Those aren't pillows.
Now, did you guys pick a baseball game because, like homosexuality, it involves a pitcher and a catcher?
That's silly. No, that's gross.
That's hot.
Was it because the Cardinals' first baseman's last name sounds like poo hole?
No, hon. You can go ahead and mock all you want.
Now go away or I shall taunt you a second time.
Jesus Christ is the Old Testament
on you.
Get out. And don't come back until you've redeemed yourselves.